Hello class, I welcome you all to this session. This session we are going to discuss the last problem in accounting equation, exercise 27. So show an accounting equation on the basis of the following transaction. Sunil started business with cash 1,50,000, opened a bank account by depositing 25,000 out of cash. So you can see that there are about 14 transactions. So what I have done, I have just started to prepare the accounting equation format. What is the format of accounting equation? Serial number, transaction. On the upper side you have assets, below that you will have what are the components of assets, and on the upper side you have capital plus liability, under that what is the capital, what are the liabilities that are there. So you can see here I have written all the transactions. So first two transactions I have written, after that I have written new equation, then third transaction, then new equation, then fourth transaction, new equation. Similarly, I have done it for the 14th transaction. You can see here, after the 14th transaction there is final equation. Okay, so all other format will be the same. So I want you all to pause the video, start copying this format and start copying information, the transactions that is given. Okay, so first transaction what is given is Sunil started business with cash. Now Sunil started business with cash, you know, asset, cash is coming in. So you'll have cash. How much of cash is coming in to the business? It is 15,000. I hope that this is clear. 1,50,000. Yeah, so 1,50,000. I am writing it under cash. And he started business, so it should be capital. So in the capital side, I am writing capital. In the liability side, I am writing the capital as 1,50,000. There is no other equation, so 1,50,000 is equal to 1,50,000. Accounting equation tally. The next transaction, opened a bank account by depositing 25,000 out of cash. Now they are opening a bank account by depositing 25,000 out of cash. Now cash is moving out of the business. Cash is moving out of the business and bank is receiving the cash. So I want you to start preparing the journal entry. What you will do, cash, what is the journal entry? Cash is a real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So cash is to be credited, bank is a personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. So bank account debit to cash account. So there are two entries here. Already you are having cash account here. Now cash account is moving out. So I am writing 25,000 in the bracket because it is to represent that it is a negative figure. Then there is a new item called as bank. Now bank, you have 25,000 coming in. Okay, so 25,000 here is negative, 25,000 here is positive, which is equal to zero. Nothing here, zero. So tally. Now new equation, 1,50,000 minus 25,000. What you are having, real cash, real cash in the business will be 1,25,000 plus 25,000 is equal to 1,50,000. Is it clear? So capital 1,50,000. Next, third transaction, he sold his personal car for 50,000 and deposited the amount in firm's bank account. So he has sold his personal car and deposited into the bank account as 50,000. Now this is it's like an additional capital. Am I right? So what we are trying to do is, 50,000 cash is coming in and he has deposited the amount into the firm bank account. So should we write cash or should we write it in bank? If you are written in cash, then it is wrong. Strike it. You have to write it in bank account because it's very clearly told that they have deposited in the firm's bank account. So here nothing, here 50,000. So it's like adding on to the capital because it's an additional money that is transferred to the firm's bank account. So obviously it has an impact in the capital. So capital goes up. Now new equation would be 1,25,000 plus 50,000 plus 25,000, which is 75,000, and you have 2 lakhs. So 1,25,000 plus 75,000, 2 lakhs. The next transaction, he purchased a building and furniture for 1 lakh. There is a new asset that's coming into the business, which is furniture and building. So furniture and building, under this I am writing 1 lakh. It doesn't affect anything. He purchased a building for 1 lakh, so obviously cash would decrease, am I right? Because he has purchased building out of cash. So 1 lakh negative balance. There is no change in bank account. So I'm just writing it zero. For this transaction alone, what is the entries I am just writing? So again here 1 lakh is a positive value. Is there any change in capital? No. So the balance, you have to look into the new equation only. Forget about these things because we have the effect stated in the new equation. So new equation, 1,25,000 minus 1 lakh, which is 25,000, plus bank balance is there 75,000, plus 1 lakh furniture and building is equal to 2 lakhs. Okay, I am sure that you are able to understand this. He paid carriage ₹500. Now this is the transaction. He paid carriage. Carriage is an expenses. He paid out of cash. So 500 reduces the cash. And always remember, if there is expenses, it would reduce the capital also. Okay, so 500, if it is reducing, the balance would be 24,500 plus 75,000 plus 1 lakh is equal to 1,99,500, because 2 lakhs minus 500. So this is the new equation. I am forgetting about all the other transactions. Okay, now sixth transaction, what we have to do, we need to forget about all these transactions. Okay, only the new transaction and this transaction should be clubbed. What is the sixth transaction? He purchased goods from Ram on credit ₹50,000. Now there is a purchase panna, what will be reduced? Capital will be reduced. Since we do not have 50,000 as our capital, what we are doing, we will be deducting that amount in bank account. Okay, since it is credit purchases, we need not worry about it. What we have to do, we need not care whether we have sufficient balance, because it is a credit purchases. It is a credit purchases. So what you are supposed to do, it is a creditors. So we need to create a liability called creditors. And there is a new thing called as stock coming into the business. So I'm just writing it here. Plus stock much worth of stock is coming into the business?
How much worth of stock is coming into the business?
50,000 worth of stock is coming into the business. And what it is that is created? Liability is created for as creditors, because we need to pay cash to the creditors later. So creditors is how much? Creditors is 50,000. So as far as this equation is concerned, 50,000 is equal to 50,000 tallied. Now what you have to look into, you need to look into the new equation. Along with this, you need to club these two and write, form another new equation. So 24,500 we have 24,500 plus 75,000, then plus 1 lakh plus 50,000 is equal to 1,99,500 plus 50,000. Is this equation tallied? We need to check. 75,000 and 1 lakh. 1,75,000 plus 2,25,000, 2,25,000 plus 24,500. I am getting the total to be 2,49,500. So this is right, 2,49,500. Yes, we are right. We will proceed with the seventh transaction here. What he sold to Shyam on credit, goods costing 6,000 for 9,000. What do you mean by this? Goods costing, stock costing 6,000 is going out of the business. Okay, so we have to reduce the stock, and so cost price is 6,000, selling price is 9,000, which means profit will be 3,000. This part is clear. So cost price will be the stock, so you need to reduce stock by 6,000. You need to add in, since it is a credit sales, okay, we need to add in debtors. Okay, here debtors will come. Debtors is how much? 9,000 positive value. Then we have 3,000 as profit, which will increase our capital. Okay, so let's do it. We are adding debtors. Okay, debtors is added. How much? 9,000, because debtor has to, selling, how much we have sold it for? We have sold it for 9,000. Selling price is 9,000. So 9,000. Stock will be reduced to the extent of 6,000. Okay. Stock will be reduced to the extent of 6,000. Then the difference is the profit. So that is a profit. So I am just mentioning profit here. Okay. So profit is a positive figure. So we need to add in the profit. So what is the new equation here? The new equation would be 24,500 plus 75,000 plus 1 lakh plus 50,000 minus 6,000, which is 44,000 plus 9,000 is equal to 1,99,500 plus 3,000, which comes to 2,02,500 plus 50,000. So the total should be 2,52,500. I'll just check whether I'm getting 2,52,500 on my asset side also. I have just now checked. I'm getting 2,52,500 here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to copy this new equation to the next side also. As you can see, I have copied the equation, the new equation, 8th transaction, rent received from tenant 1,000. So rent is received in the form of cash, it increases the cash value, and it is an income. Income will increase the capital. Okay, so this becomes 25,500 plus 75,000 plus 1 lakh plus 44,000 plus 9,000, 2,03,500 plus 50,000. Now received a security deposit from tenant rupees 1,500. Now 1,500 received in the form of cash, so it will increase the cash value, and 1,500 is a security deposit. If you know that security deposit needs to be repaid when the tenant is actually vacating the premises, so I am just taking it as a liability, security deposit. So security deposit 1,500. Okay, so this is my new entry here. So what we have to do, the new equation would be 25,500 plus 1,500, 27,000. Yeah, 27,000 plus 75,000 plus 1,00,000 plus 44,000 plus 9,000. Here I am having 2,03,500 plus 50,000 plus 1,500. My new equation is ready. I am forgetting about the previous equation. Now the next equation that I have to form with this new equation and this extra equation, 10th equation, 10th transaction, purchased stationery for cash rupees 100. Now purchase stationery for cash, it's an expenses, stationery cash goes out, so 26,900, then it is an expenses, so it will reduce my capital also because it's an expenses, so I'm just deducting. I'll get 2,03,400 plus 50,000 plus 1,500. Here 75,000, 1,00,000, 44,000, 9,000. I will forget this previous equations, new equation along with this new transaction. Invested in shares for personal use. Now 50,000 is being invested into the shares for personal use. So I am taking from bank account because the bank balance is 75,000 here. If you want to invest in shares, obviously you need to have a bank account and a demat account. So I am taking that logic. So I am applying here. So I am deducting from bank balance, not from the cash balance. So bank balance is 75,000. I am deducting 50,000. New equation would be the remaining balance would be only 25,000 in bank balance. All other balance will be equal. Since it is for personal purpose, it will reduce my capital. It will be treated as a drawings. So 50,000 drawings. So if I am deducting 50,000 from 2,03,400, so this will be, if I am deducting this, 1,53,400, my capital is reduced. All other balances will be the same. So creditors 50,000, security deposit 1,500, cash balance 26,900, 25,000, 1,00,000, 44,000 stock, 9,000 debtors. Next transaction, received interest in cash rupees 200. It is an income because you are receiving interest in cash, so it is an income. It will increase the cash balance. So 27,100, and it will increase my capital also because it is an income. Okay, so 1,53,500, not 500, 600. Okay, just 600, because 1,53,400 plus 200 is 1,53,600. So all others are the same. So I'm just writing creditors 50,000, security deposit 1,500. Okay, security deposits 1,500, and all other equations are the same. 25,000, 1,00,000, 44,000, 9,000. Okay, next one, introduced fresh capital 25,000. So the next transaction will be this one. So 25,000 is in fresh capital introduced. So it will increase the cash balance here, and then it will increase the capital also. So I'm just adding this 25,000 here. So 25,000 plus 27,100 is 52,100 plus 25,000 bank balance, 1 lakh furniture and building, 44,000 stock, 9,000 debtors, 1,53,600 plus 25,000 1,78,600 capital, 50,000 creditors, 1,500 security deposit, goods destroyed by fire. Now goods 44,000 is destroyed by fire. How much worth of goods is destroyed by fire? It's given here. 500 worth of goods is destroyed by fire. So I'm just going to deduct 500 from stock, and it is like a loss, so it would affect the capital also. So 500 deducted as loss. Now what is my capital? 1,78,100 plus 50,000 plus 1,500. Here cash 52,100, bank balance 25,000, 1 lakh building and furniture, 43,500 stock, 9,000 is debtors. Now we are going to prepare the balance sheet here in order to understand whether really assets are equal to liability. Okay, so what are the liabilities that are there? Always liability will be in the left, assets will be in the right. Okay, so rupees. So we are going to start preparing our balance sheet. So liabilities, what are the liabilities that was there? Capital 1,78,100, capital, creditors and security deposit. Capital, creditors, security deposits. Okay, so how much is the capital? 1,78,100. Security deposit is 50,000. Security deposit is 1,500. Not 1 lakh, 1,500. And creditors is 50,000. So we are going to copy this same. 1,78,100. What are the assets that are there? Assets that are there is cash, bank, furniture, building, stock and debtors. So we're going to write that cash, bank, furniture and building, stock and debtors. Okay, so cash is how much? 52,100. Bank 25,000, furniture and building 1 lakh, 43,500 stock and 9,000 is debtors. So okay, so I have just written all the items. So we'll check whether liabilities tallies the asset. I'm getting the answer after adding all these items. I'm getting 2,29,600. Even here I am getting 2,29,600. So our liability is equal to asset, or asset is equal to liability is tallied. So this is how you have to do the accounting equation problems. This is just to check. It's not asked in the question. It's just to check whether our answer is right. You can just prepare this. You can just add it and check whether your assets are equal to your liability. Keep practicing. This is a challenging problem. I would give you some homework problem that you need to complete so that you will be comfortable with this chapter. Okay? I want you to type illustration 3, this question, and illustration 4, this question, and illustration 6, 7, as well as all the other illustration. You can just have a glance, but illustration 6, 7 compulsorily you have to do it in your classwork, and illustration 3, 4, 5 compulsorily you have to do it in your classwork, and all the other problems that I have not personally worked out. Okay, so these are the exercise problem. I wouldn't have worked out some problems here. So I want you all to try those problems in your textbook. It may not be worked out by me. So please finish those problems. And there is some evaluation questions. You can also try these questions whether you are able to answer. Solution is also there in your textbook. So you very well you can just like that try. There are two problems like this. So we have completed the accounting equation chapter. So keep practicing. I'll see you in the next chapter. The next chapter that we are going to do is journal. Okay. Thank you, class.